Welcome back, Minecraft Beth is here. Today I have a very, well, it's a bit less redstone intense than my usual builds, and a bit less command block intense. But it's pretty big, just disclaimer, I didn't exactly build it, I used a lot of cloning. It's a more mathematical thing, but whether or not you're into it, here it is! Yeah, probably looks something like what you would see through an LSD trip. This is what's known as a Menzer's sponge. It is a three-dimensional fractal that I have recreated in Minecraft. Now let me explain a bit of the way this works. Quickly I'll give you some stats on it. It has 160,000 blocks of gold in it. I mean, I just chose gold because it's called a Menzer's sponge. Why not make it look like a sponge? Or I could have built it out of sponge. That might have been smart. This is known as a level 4 Menzer sponge. And, 160,000 blocks of gold. 81 by 81 by 81. I think it's pretty cool. It's a fractal, which is... I'll explain it in a little bit if you haven't heard of it already. Fractals. Fractals are like self-repeating shapes. And it's quite interesting to see one and fly through one. This is what's known as a level 4 Menzer sponge, which you'll soon figure out why. So let me show you where is my little models. I made models for this video over here. Yeah, so basically, this is what's known as a level 1 Menzer sponge. So this thing right here is actually composed of 8,000 of these. It's composed of 8,000 of these little, like, 20 block of gold, small Menzer sponges. And, so yeah, this is entirely made out of those, placed right next to each other. Now, the way fractal works is, fractal is like any shape, like this, but it's built... but it's multiple of them built in the shape of themselves, so this is like a Menzer sponge built out of Menzer sponges, and that's why it's known as a level 2 Menzer sponge. And if you built a Menzer sponge out of these Menzer sponges, then you get a level 3 Menzer sponge. And if you build another Menzer sponge out of those, then you get this. And, I can build this by hand. I would literally have no time to do it. I would make a lot of mistakes. So what I did is I, simply did cloning. This is the level 4 Menzer sponge because it's a Menzer sponge built out of these Menzer sponge, and then another it's four levels of Menzer sponges. That's the simplest way to explain. This is level 1. This is a Menzer sponge built out of Menzer sponges. Then this is a Menzer sponge built out of Menzer sponges of lots of Menzer sponges. Look it up. Okay. But the interesting thing about this is, so this is a very famous mathematical thing. There are many famous fractals, such as the Sierpinski triangle. Look it up. I think I'm pronouncing that right. There's also the Mandelbrot set, which is not really three-dimensional, but there are Mandelbrots. The interesting thing about seeing a fractal visualized in 3D in Minecraft is you could really fly through it, and you could sort of discover things that you would never discover otherwise. Like, with just pure math, you wouldn't discover that when you fall into one of the holes, you go right down to the bottom. Like, that's something you might have not figured out, unless you actually have a Menzer sponge to fly around through. Now, could you build a level 5 Menzer sponge? Yes, you could, actually. That would be 243 blocks high, which would almost scrape the build limit, but not quite. And there are ones on YouTube, but the problem is, since this, the problem is, A, it would be very laggy to clone, and I have a moderately fast computer. And problem 2, you actually can't clone something this big. You have, at most, 32,768 blocks in which you can clone. So I actually can't clone this. You'd have to use MCEdit for that. Now, I want you to get a bit of a size comparison, because I believe there's a village nearby. So you could get a bit of a size comparison of how big this level 4 Menzer sponge is compared to this village. So it's quite a big thing. It's quite a nice thing to look at, quite a nice thing to fly through. Anyways, that's it for this, I guess the list. A couple less things to mention, more mathematical things. So, there's sort of this really interesting thing about fractals. Infinite symmetry. So it's symmetrical. This is sort of, like, the most symmetrical thing possible. In a way, I mean, spheres sort of are, but you can divide this, like, in almost any way. Like, you could, for one thing, divide it in half, divide it up, all those ways. You could also divide it diagonally. But moreover, really interestingly, symmetry appears in these things in the craziest ways. Even, like, the gaps between here. Like, look. 1, 3, 1, 9, 1, 3, 1, 27. And, 1, 3, 1, 9, 1, 3. Yeah, you get the idea. It has these, like, weird patterns literally everywhere. It's truly fascinating. So yeah, I guess you could, if you want, you could build one, clone one for yourself. That's about it. I just decided to show this off because I built this in my free time. And yeah, it's pretty cool. I hope you think it's pretty cool anyways. A couple last things to mention. How do I know it's 160,000 blocks? It's because you can actually calculate the number of blocks in a Menzier sponge by, doing 20 to the power of the level. So, level 1 is 20, this one's 400 blocks, then 8,000, this one's 160,000 blocks. Thanks everyone for watching! I hope you have a great day, I hope that you have enjoyed this gigantic Menzier sponge built in Minecraft, and goodbye.